We're gonna start making some pizzas, okay? We are gonna do a sheet pan pizza, so we're gonna make it like a nice rectangle. You don't need very much flour on the pan itself. We're gonna get just a little bit on the dough. And then we're just gonna roll back and forth. I've never used this rolling pin before, so it's kind of weird. It doesn't have handles or anything. Leave it to my wife to get a special rolling pin.
I didn't see the ones with handles, and I have seen the little ones. Actually, I have seen the little ones with handles, and I don't know, they're weird. So this is like a French style rolling pin.
So we're just going back and forth here, guys. And if you notice it's sticking to the counter or sticking to your rolling pin, add just a little bit more flour. We're just gonna keep rolling with the punches. Mm-hmm. We're gonna sprinkle a very little bit of flour on the bottom of our baking sheet.
Yes, remember guys, flour is a raw food item. You do not want to eat it raw, it's gross. And the dough itself is vegan. If you guys notice, we don't add any egg or anything like that to it. It's just flour and some sugar and some salt, and it's our special blend that we blend like a couple times a week at the restaurant.
Katie's mom invented this delicious recipe.
Mm-hmm. So you want the flour on the bottom to cook as well. All right, so now that we've got...
So we have ours in our sheet pan, right? Mm-hmm. So we are going to make some pizza now. We're gonna start with our sauce, okay? Just remember guys, start off lighter on the sauce. You can always add more, but nobody wants a soggy pizza, okay? And we're just gonna use a spoon to spread it. We're gonna put a couple dollops on there. And we're gonna just spread it around nice and evenly. Leave yourself about an inch around the crust, maybe half an inch if you're not a big crust person. But the sauce is gonna melt out towards the edges a little and you don't want it running all over the place. If you have like a flat bottom ladle or something, you wanna use that instead, feel free. Or you can just pour it on there and get crazy and use your hands, whatever you like.
Flat bottom ladle, Carlo. That is a professional item. Who has that in their kitchen?
That's a queen zone. Those flat bottom ladles.
Flat bottom ladles make the world go round, guys. Yeah. You heard it here first.
All right, so Katie is an extra sauce person.
Oh, yes.
So we are
going to
put a little extra on, just be aware. You can go lighter or heavier, but don't go too heavy because you'll get a nice soggy pizza. Okay, so we've got our sauce on there. That's what it's gonna look like. All right. Next thing you're gonna wanna do is put a little bit of cheese, okay? Cheese is what's gonna help your toppings stick. If you don't put any before the toppings, you take a bite, it's just gonna pull everything off with you.
And then, Carlo's gonna be pretty boring. You're gonna put cheese on your pizza, that's it?
And pineapple.
Oh, and pineapple too, cool.
So Katie's gonna do some spinach. So we're gonna spread that out a little bit.
That's one of our things too, in theory, like spinach is like a bigger item, so we put it on the bottom. It does leach a lot of moisture, but hopefully like when you cook your pizza, it doesn't, because it cooks pretty quickly, it doesn't really have a chance to make it soggy.
Like Katie's saying, any toppings you have that have extra moisture in them, especially something like pineapple or tomatoes. Just be aware that they're gonna make your pizza a little bit soggier. What we always do is if you're doing pineapple and you can squeeze it, mm-hmm. to kind of get some of that moisture out. I know it's delicious, but just like take it in your hand and squeeze it.
What's not delicious is a soggy pizza.
Yeah, so we squeeze it all out, get all that liquid out as much as we can. And then we're gonna spread that on there. Tomatoes, it's a little harder to do that because you don't want mush. And now we're gonna finish off with cheese, okay? So spread it around. Whole milk mozzarella is the cheese of choice for pizza places. Just remember, if you're doing it at home and you didn't get one of our pizza kits, the better the quality ingredients, the better your pizza's gonna turn out. So don't get the cheapest cheese at the store. It'll still be good because our crust is delicious, but another mistake people make all the time is they put way too much cheese on their pizza. Just remember that if you put too much on, it's not gonna melt.
Yeah.
We're gonna add a little bit of like seasoning on top if you guys wanna add any like garlic powder or basil or oregano. Now's a really good time to do it so it cooks in there. Better than doing it after it comes out. There's a little oregano, a little basil, whatever toppings you guys are putting on there. Get those all on there. You, like Katie said, you want to start with the largest topping first, generally speaking.
What did you put on?
Basil and oregano.
Oh, and garlic.
Yeah. So if you have, you know, pepperoni as a topping, that's probably usually going to go at the very bottom of the pizza. Olives, onions, mushrooms, those things are going to go higher up towards the top of the pizza. It'll help them cook better.
And not be as soggy. Mushroom is another one of those items, the vegetable items, that produces a lot of moisture. So the further up you can get it off your pizza, the less soggy the pizza will be.
All right, so our pizza is ready to go in the oven.
All right, guys.
Our pizza is done and delicious looking. You will notice we've got some nice cheese browning going on. If you put on too much cheese, that's never going to happen. We obviously put the right amount, thank God. And there's our pizza, perfectly coming out.
Roman, you want to see this pizza?
No, of course not.
Of course not.
So we're going to cut our pizza. You can let it sit for a minute if you want to first, but we're hungry.
Yeah.
We're going to eat some pizza.
Definitely recommend getting a pizza cutter in your life.
Yeah, if you don't have one, I don't even know what you're doing. Get a pizza cutter.
Get a pizza cutter.
This one's from Japan.
It's
we bought it when we were in Japan. Well, it came for free.
Yeah, right? It came for free with...
Katie bought a fancy knife and it came with her fancy knife. So yeah, our pizza came out really nicely. The bottom is like a nice, delicious golden brown.
Mm-hmm. That's what you're looking for. And it should be like, when you, if you really wanted to, you could tap it and it would be like crusty.
Yeah, here, go ahead. Give it a knock.
Give it a knock. I don't know if you can hear that, but it's good.
It's perfect. Don't forget to turn off your oven.
I'm forever guilty of not turning
off. Katie never turns off the oven. It's okay. So that's our pizza. If you guys have any questions and can't get it from the video, just send us a message through our Facebook page. We check it all the time. So either through Frederick or through Hagerstown, just send us a message and we can answer any questions you guys have, okay?